Flores. We are on the Crush Red Velvet. Good morning to you, Robert Flores, Bill Ripken. I'm Lauren Shahadi. Early
morning, Bill.
Call for you.
It was all good.
We love having you here.
Thank you. I love being here.
You low key do, don't you?
He does. He likes us more than he lets on.
He loves when we have fan interaction on social media.
Yeah, love it.
All of it.
Just something to say. Marco Gonzalez, Stephen Piscotty joining the program in just a little bit, and we are leading you up to live baseball, Dodgers and Cardinals on this Thursday. Are you, any of you, by chance, germaphobes?
No, I am not.
So look away. I'm talking to you.
James Paxton has had good success against the Astros, obviously as a member of the Seattle Mariners, but Altuve was a dominant force in this three-game sweep.
When he's right, isn't he always? We get it. We see what Mookie Betts has done over the past.
From Chandler Rome, who's the beat writer for the Houston Chronicle, covers the Astros.
Have your legs underneath you when you're hitting, and we've seen Miguel Cabrera. Now, these are two different type body styles and the way they approach it, but Miguel Cabrera's been having trouble with his lower half, and he's not the same guy. And eyes, the barrel gets from here to here pretty quick, and when this is coming in at 90-plus, it's going to leave pretty quick.
First time in franchise history that the Astros have swept the Yankees in a series. All right, let's move on.
Loud JP Morosi on the inside corner. Capiche, good morning to you. Every single time we watch a Mets game, okay, thank you, or see a highlight, it's Pete Alonso, front and center. Mets fans thinking, thank goodness he's finally on the opening day roster. What are you thinking when you watch him play? Alonso and I graduated same year at UF. Did you know that? Why are you laughing?
I did know
Robert,
that. Well,
I'm
done.
Kidding. Relax. Jeez. He said it's a bold-faced lie. Whatever. We're focusing on the good, JP, and the good is Tyler Glass. Now, 99-minute delay doesn't matter, didn't affect him at all. Did you know this was his ceiling, that he was this good, had this potential? Took you 2 weeks. You're slipping. You knew that was on there. You made our bingo board. I feel like you're famous. Hey, we're looking for the
good. Only a little bit, but thank you.
We're looking for the good for the Cubs, right? Did you watch Yu Darvish? Sure, four earned and 5 1/3. Were there positive takeaways watching him? Hoping for improvement. We are certainly rooting for him. JP Morosi, thank you, my friend. Appreciate the time. Let's take a break on MLB Central. I have no idea. To you, we got work to do. Of course we do. And we've assessed the slow start by the Red Sox a time or two and come to the conclusion that it starts with starting pitching. Does it end there, Ken?
It does not, Lauren. And it's interesting with the Red Sox. If you were the lineup to be more like George Springer, well, guess what? They're going to try to do, I'm sure, in the days ahead, is get more.
I was speaking with Alex Cora last postseason. He said, first pitch down the middle, swing. So why would that approach change? It's not the approach that's changing. It's what's coming to fruition is what you're saying.
I don't know why it's changed. And I'm sure the Red Sox are asking themselves that question because they were so successful, Lauren, doing it the other.
Ending it, we will see. We are not surprised these days by extensions, the way things are going, right?
Right.
Matt Carpenter, did that surprise you at all, the timing of it?
It did. Because he has a club option or had a club option for 2020, and this extension covers his ages 34 and 35 seasons, 2020-21, with an option for 22. That would be his age 36 season.
A wonderful person, 36 home runs, all because of the salsa, of course.
That's right.
Right? Forget about his presence.
And remember, too, Lauren,
important.
Fifth year season.
Very nice. You and I have talked about the Padres' interest in Dallas Keuchel. Doesn't seem to be a marriage right now, although a veteran arm in that rotation would certainly look good. You're focusing on something else, someone else, a younger starter.
Well, Lauren, one of the things I love most about the game is when guys who are not heralded make an up in spring training and is in major league camp, but not really expected to be a factor for their rotation.
In the West.
Hosmer has to say that.
Of
but
course.
He might be right. Who knows?
It fires me up. I love him.
Yeah.
Ken, thanks so much. Appreciate the time. Let's take a break on Central. Hey, we all know Whit Merrifield.